Yeah, probably not a typical one for many people. My mum actually got me into boxing. So when I was 7, where we lived, it was like a minute down from the local gym, local boxing gym. So yeah, I must have been a bit of a hypo kid. She took me down, and I've done it ever since. Yeah, since I was 7. I just think, especially living up, growing up in a quite a rough area, I think obviously it's led me down the right path. You know, it's helped me to, you know, stay off the streets. And a lot of people when I was younger, you know, 13, 14, that type of age, they've all went into like jail and that now. So it's probably saved me a little bit, put me on the right path. And you know, you got to be disciplined. And yeah, I think it's just given me a way of life now, and obviously set me up for a career for the rest of my life now, hopefully. I think present now, it's definitely have to be Lomachenko, my favourite fighter. I don't think it's going many rounds. Like, he's obviously one of the best fighters in the world, but I'd definitely love to share the ring with him and try and pick his brain and learn something from him. Probably Marvin Hagler, a fighter that I'll probably watch most. I don't watch a lot of past fighters, but if it was anyone, I reckon it'd be Marvin Hagler. So obviously as a professional now, I'm only 3-0. Opponents that I've faced haven't been obviously the best of calibers, but I'd have to say from my amateur days, my last amateur fight, I fought a lad, he was a tough lad, I think the Olympic bronze medalist, and yeah, it was all out war, so I'd have to say that was probably my toughest fight to date. I think, you know what, I think it's just another learning year for me. Like I say, I'm only 3-0. So hopefully get another 5-6 fights maybe next year, stay busy, and then push on then, maybe 2023, push on for titles hopefully. But yeah, just another learning year for me, get the rounds in, and go from there.